just kidding guys, it was water, but I do have soju with me. It's just that most of you aren't even 25, so I don't want to like promote this. And yeah, obviously you can drink once you're like an adult, but for now let's just keep it to water. It tastes like tequila, but in general I would say like that's my expression whenever I drink soju. I feel like it's like tequila. In any case, my name is Sherry. Welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are doing well, all safe at home. I am all chill, just sitting at home doing my thing. But today I had the motivation to come up and make a YouTube video because I just had to do my hair and put on some lipstick. That's pretty much about it, because it's gonna be a fun chit chatty video and a pretty I would say like a controversial video because of K-dramas, because I know you and I love K-dramas. So let's see what do we like. And if you want to watch more such videos, then like this video, subscribe to my channel, comment down below as to whatever you want to watch, and let's go. Believe that you and I are in the same boat of loving K-dramas. Oh my god, I am like an hopelessly romantic person. Just make me watch K-drama and their love stories and I'm like yeah. And while I'm at it, I thought of multitasking and doing some skincare. And the best skincare regime which I can do right now while talking about my favorite shows is using a sheet mask. You know how Korean skin is, like the guys, the girls, they have like such glowing plump skin. I know they, Korea has like an unrealistic beauty standard which they follow. I'm also happy that we actually don't really run after such specific beauty standards. I think every skin is beautiful and we all are beautiful, and I'm pretty happy that we accept it the way we are. But there's no harm doing some good things to your skin just to keep it happy and just to keep your skin fresh. And the one which I'm using right now is the L'Oreal Paris Hyaluronic Acid Sheet Mask. It's not your regular mask, guys. I mean, it's a game changer totally to keep your skin like fresh, hydrated, plump, radiant, and you know, it just improves the quality of your skin. So before I start with all my K-drama stories, let me just tell you a little about my sheet mask before like applying it. It comes in like two compartments which you can see. This is a dry sheet mask, which means that it's made out of algae extract. It can absorb 20x of its own weight in water. In simple terms, basically it will absorb all of this here. So this part is the liquid serum, which is the concentrated hyaluronic acid. It's not diluted and it's the right amount of hyaluronic acid which goes into our skin. So you know, when you push this product right here, it absorbs all of it and it makes it less dripping. And when you put it on your face, it's the perfect size. And since most of you are in the age of like 19-20, once you hit that age of 20, I mean, you know, your skin gets a lot more exposure outside and it just becomes like dull and like very dehydrated and like, you know, all those things. So you know, it helps you in keeping your skin alive, very plump, youthful and glowing with just hyaluronic acid. And this is why you need this in your skincare regime. And I've been using their like hyaluronic serum, and now they, you know, introduced it to the sheet mask, so it's obviously a win-win situation for me. And it also helps you maintain the moisture of your skin because it can hold up to 1000 times of its own weight in water. It's very simple to use. It's a very breathable mask and very affordable, I would say. It's just for $199, and if you regularly use it, you will see a visible difference. And for this sheet mask, I mean, it's fun to use. I mean, you know, you make your own sheet mask in general. I mean, you have the serum and you have the dry sheet, so you know, you are making your own sheet mask right now, and I'm gonna do it. So you just basically have to, there's a sign right here that you have to press it. Literally empty, there is nothing left, and this part has all the serum. Oh my god, this is oddly satisfying. If I should start with like 1 to 10 or like 10 to 1, but I'm sure like we might have a similar list. Let's see ki kiski ranking kya hoti hai in the comment section below. My first one, and I know everybody is saying it and everybody has said it in their own little world, that their favorite K-drama and my favorite K-drama has to be crash landing on you. Oh my god, if you want to watch a K-drama which can make you cry, watch that. I was literally so sad that the K-drama ended and I was like, oh my god, why did the show end? And I was crying and my heart was like, oh shit, that was really good. Like, I mean, it's a good mix of like action, comedy. Both the characters are so powerful, and like, it's not like one character is weak and the other is powerful. It's like both the characters are powerful. Are you guys with me in this? I think my second favorite has to be Healer. First of all, I wasn't watching that show for the longest time because I was like, yaar, pata nahi kaisa hoga. But then when I started, I actually felt so good. It's not like a fantasy, but like, I haven't seen humans who can do like such crazy stuff which Healer used to do, like night messenger sort of thing. I'm sure people like them exist, but obviously I haven't really come across such people, so I don't know whether such sort of hacking and like tracking and all these things can happen. Plus, like, even the girl, I'm not too good with the name, so I'm just not gonna name them, but you know what I'm talking about. Their love story is also like, you know, tough situations, and like, there's a love story, so obviously I really like that. And I like the fact that she loved a person without looking at him, like, you know, age, face, things did not matter to her. So, you know, it's sort of that way. I was a little disappointed with the ending. I mean, you know how they caught that boss guy and how things were. I mean, I expected a better ending, but obviously it was a happy ending, so yeah. My third favorite has to be like Dissonance of the Sun. Again, like, it was a tough love situation. I'm sure like these things, I mean, at least here with me, doesn't like, such extreme things don't happen here, and I don't know if it actually happens, but then it just teaches us that, you know, love has to be there in at all points, like easy love, tough love, it should be there. It just sort of like makes me like, I'm a hopeless romantic, guys. And it was such a well shot show. In case you want to watch it, definitely give it a try. My fourth one is Legends of the Blue Sea. Now again, it's a fantasy drama, and obviously such things don't happen in real life, but, and that's why I think I did not watch it again for the longest time. I used to watch like some different K-dramas, and these are the shows I actually left it for the end. But I realized, why didn't I watch this earlier? Oh my god, like Legends of the Blue Sea, oh, it was so funny and cute. Like, I really liked the acting, like, it was really cute. Like, it was just so like, it was the perfect blend of like comedy, love, and like obviously fantasy. But yeah, the ending was also like, I really live for those endings, because like the ending where like she went to the ocean and then she came back and stuff like that. Okay, next one has to be My Love from the Star. Now again, it's a fantasy drama and the same actress. I really liked how he lived for like so many years and people started recognizing him later and things like that. Again, it was a very superficial fantasy sort of thing, but really liked their chemistry, and it just made me hooked onto that show. Like, I got dark circles, like I watched it like all night long. The next one has to be like Doctor Stranger. Again, like, I know it's a little bit too melodramatic, and like one doctor performing all sorts of surgeries, which is obviously not really possible, but and especially with his eyes closed and like stuff like that, I haven't really seen such things happening here. I mean, it's a little OTT. My next favorite K-drama has to be like Weightlifting, Fairy K Kim Bok Cho. Oh god, I forgot only. But it's like, I don't really remember anything after I watched the show. When I'm watching it, I'm like into it, but after a few days, I don't even remember what really happened, because obviously I'm watching it with subtitles and everything. But I mean, it was a sweet, it was a good blend of like college life, the athlete life and everything, the struggles, the hardships, and the entire show went on with like a smooth ending rather than like a very dramatic ending at the end. So I don't know, I think this should have come earlier. I don't know why am I rating it an 8, but my next one has to be Secret Garden. Again, it was a very fantasy thing where the bodies switch up and things like that. I mean, it doesn't really happen in real life, but it was just so fun to watch. I was having a hard time back then, so it just made me laugh, because when the body switched and all those fun things that happened, the show was really cool. So I feel like that was one thing which I really liked about the show. My next one has to be Boys Over Flowers. I mean, they have like 3-4 different editions. Like, one is in Chinese, the other is a Korean one. I'm forgetting which one is what. I think Boys Over Flowers is the Korean one, if I'm not wrong. It's a very, very old show, and like, it's all about like how those three boys and that girl, obviously the rich and the poor. Oh my god, that's such a stereotypical thing in K-dramas. Everything is like a rich versus poor, I feel. But otherwise, like, I think that love was just so very, very good to watch, and that it just kept me hooked. The last one, Strong Girl Bong Soon. Again, I think by this time I've realized that fantasy dramas are something which I really like watching. I think, again, you can't be possibly that superhero in that life, but it was a good blend of comedy, that love, that the entire scenario that happened, and how she found like the serial killer. So it was just fun to watch. So, you know, most of the K-dramas are very, very fun to watch in case you want to give it a try. It has a good blend of comedy, it has a good blend of love, mostly love, it has a good blend of like fantasy scenes and stuff like that. So it's a very cool thing to watch. And let me know if my list matches yours, and my skincare routine is also done. There is no edit, there is no filter. If you see, my skin is literally glowing and all the serum is literally absorbed and there is nothing left on my skin. So I'm just gonna give it a good massage, and this is what it feels like when you apply a hyaluronic sheath mask. It's just so good to do some skincare, and I think you should do it too, especially now you're at home, you have all the time to take care of your skin. I'm gonna put all the links down below for you guys. Let me know what are your thoughts on this video, and I'll see you very, very soon. Like this video, subscribe to my channel, comment down below, and let me know other K-dramas which I can watch. And yeah, see you soon. Bye.